If you own an e-commerce store, then you've got to run an abandoned checkout flow. You also really need to run an abandoned cart flow, which I'll cover in another video. But today I'm just going to show you how you can set up a basic abandoned checkout flow in Klaviyo. So let's jump into it. So once you're in Klaviyo, you click on flows and then create flow, then search for cart. Don't search for checkout because you won't find anything. If you have Shopify, you can choose one of the Shopify options. If you've got another e-commerce system, you can choose, say, the standard one. Klaviyo has recently updated their flows. I'm just going to grab this one and I'll just delete this conditional split here. Makes it a little bit easier. So starting from the top, the flow filters are evaluated at each step of the flow before the email gets sent. So what this means is that if someone has placed an order 0 times since starting the flow, then when that's evaluated, they will get this email after 4 hours. However, if they have placed an order, then they'll get dropped out of the flow at that point. Something else that you should include as well is if someone has not been in this flow in the last, say, 14 days, just so that if people do abandon their checkout a lot, they don't get this email over and over again in a short space of time. So we've got a 4-hour wait here. You may want to play around with that particular wait. If you click on edit email, you can see it's got this product block here, but it's not actually populated until you click on preview and test. And now you can cycle through the checkout started events and you can see how it would appear, and it uses the data from that person's event. So that's email number one. And just for some ideas on how other brands have handled that, here's one from Herschel. You can see they're using that dynamic product block in the middle there. And here's another one from Hydro Center. So we've got a little more personalized email there, but once again, using that dynamic product block in the middle. So let's go to email number two, and we can quickly jump to that just by selecting the second email from this screen. So we're offering free shipping, which you may want to do. You may just want to remind people that they've got their items in their cart. In my experience, it doesn't make a whole lot of difference. As long as somebody is getting a reminder, you need to send at least 2 reminders, and usually a third and perhaps a fourth if your click-through rate is still good. If you click the Klaviyo icon, it takes you one step backwards. And you can see in the subject line here, we're using a template tag to title case someone's first name. And if we don't know what their name is, we're going to say, guess what? And you qualify for free shipping. So that was email number two. And here's some examples of how other brands do email number two. So here's one from Byte, a little bit more about the product, a quote from a customer and the products that are in the cart. And here's one from Nugs. Nugs has got a smaller selection in their catalog, so they go without using the items that you've got in your cart and jump straight into offering a coupon code, which if you use a system like Shopify, you can insert a dynamic coupon code in there that's individualized for that particular person who's receiving the email. So once you're happy with your email flow, you just click on update action statuses. If you set them to live, everything goes live at that point, or you can activate each individual email using this little menu here. So manual will not actually send people any emails, but it will queue them up so you can send the emails to them later if you want to. If it's in draft, it won't do anything at all. So that's how you set up an abandoned checkout flow. You also need to have an abandoned cart flow, and I'm going to have a separate video about that one. And if you want to know how you can utilize more personalized text heavy emails as opposed to the usual image heavy emails, then take a look at this video over here, and I'll catch you in the next one.